I'm Robert Schmidt.
How do you, Robert?
Glad to meet you, sir. I'm VA's boy. Of the 300.
Oh, okay.
I got bigger pictures of it down there. But you guys are doing such a beautiful job.
Thank you.
This makes the heart die, makes me feel good.
Good.
I realize things, you know, happen, and they only last so long.
Yeah. Well, like I said, if we would have a better system, you know, for blowing down.
Sure.
And we're using that chemical now.
Yes.
I don't think that would have happened.
Mm-hmm.
And like I said, our water.
Well, now, Dad had a wider treatment staying in here as far as the water when he even had it down here a long time ago. You know,
yeah,
that quantity.
Yeah,
but, you know, that stuff all goes haywire, too. I realize that.
Yeah, we religiously treat it now. And,
sure.
And we blow it down.
Oh, sure.
And then in the winter, we go and we pull all the plugs, wash it. Then we go and we circulate acid in the boil. It's made for that.
Okay.
And then we flush it, and then, you know, we pull all the plugs and everything to drain it. So hopefully we won't ever have that again.
Well, now they say they're going to turn the 300 into a 262.
That'd be nice.
Here's the nameplate of Dad's engine when it was built.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
And that's the...
That's the 300.
Okay.
This is off the 300. And when we was talking, standing there talking, Dad made these. These set on the back of the tender.
Cool.
But it was never put on the engine.
Okay.
It was never put on there. He had ones made for the front. Of course, they all got melted. Because they redone them. They used metal handrail ends and used them for, you know, for the lights up on the front. But
okay.
these here, Dad had made them.
Wow.
Back in 1958.
Wow.
This was taken down in Alton at a place called Fraser's Playland, where Dad ran the engine back in 1960. And where's the other picture, Glenda?
I have it right here.
Okay. Here's another better picture of it. When he was... This is also back in the... Yeah, this was up at Brown's Road in St. Louis.
Did you hang out there too when he
was... Yes. Well, yeah, because he was a member since 1942.
Okay.
I helped him work on this thing and helped build it and turn wheels and stuff like that.
Wow. You know, the angle of that makes it look like it's a real size train.
Yeah, that's why I had them do it up like this. I took one of these pictures. I got lots of them. Here's pictures when my dad was building it, of all things. But what I'm going to do, I'm going to make a collage type thing for you guys, and so you can hang it up down here. Because when the engine caught on fire that time, I don't know if these are going to show up in there. This is a House of David running gear. That was what was on the 300.
Okay.
Of course, Dad made all the frame. All he had, all he got was the drive wheels and the pistons and stuff like that. All the trucks and everything. He made all this.
Oh.
See, down through the years. Yeah, that's another picture. That's not a very good one. But I've acquired all these pictures of it. See, even when it caught on fire, that's all they had to go by to help try to get it back together the other time.
Right, they didn't have the plans.
There is no plans for this.
It's a one-off, it's unique.
It's a one-off unique. There's that boiler sitting out there.
Wow.
That was built in Ott Boiler Company in Springfield. Eh?
Wow.
When they built it up there. And they would only work on it when Dad would go up there. They'd only work on it on the weekends because he was a code boiler builder.
Oh.
But have your own boiler, he could not make it. Because
right.
He has to be certified by someone
right.
else.
Right.
So
he could sit and watch it. And
he'd go up there and help him build it. He'd go up there and help him build it. But he couldn't certify it,
right.
See.
Yeah.
But he was a code boiler builder.
Wow. Well, was that his main job?
And then his main job, he worked for Modern Plumbing and Heating in Woodruff, Illinois.
As a welder.
As a welder. He'd go out on the job and that. And this is my wife, by the way, Glenda. And he would go out on a job and help figure jobs in his later years.
Okay.
because he retired when he was 64, and he lived to 69. And when he was 69, when he passed, in 1974, he passed away. And then the train was already down here by then.
Yeah. And this is stuff you discovered by going through.
This is something I have known about this for over 20 years. Say, and my brother sent all this stuff to me, so okay. I'm going back to what I'm doing. I got one of the Lionel trains. I'm doing a thing from memory of my dad. It's a Lionel train. It's a steam locomotive just like the one he had, and it's a 442 Atlantic, and they only built 500 of them last year, and I got the last one Lionel had this last year, and I'm going to put it in my basement, 160 foot of track, and I'm trying to get cars and everything just like he had.
Wow. Okay.
When they had it down here.
Yeah. Wow.
That's why I'm going through all this.
Yeah.
Stuff. Let me get here where you get some pictures. You can really see it better. This is when it was being built. What it is, it's a diesel locomotive. There's like an F3, I think they call them. I think that's what they are. And that's my youngest brother said. This is 1948. And this is built on Western Avenues when they was building it. And this had a four-cylinder Hercules motor in it. And let me get some good pictures here. Whoop. Of it. I got a colored picture of it too here. This is when we first started running it. We ran it at all the school picnics and things like that. It's called the W&M, the Western, Aberdeen, and Milton. That's where they live.
Uh-huh.
Dad lived on Western Avenue. His partner that passed away. This was at the Westerner Club. There's Ebert Turner, his partner that helped build the thing. And that was for it was painted. They built it for the fire department picnics they had at the old Milton School up in Alton.